next week. Good to talk to you. Thank you.
Thank you. Please remain standing for our national anthem. Faculty, students, parents, friends, trustees, and members of the class of 2021, good morning and welcome to Buckley Country Day School's 94th commencement exercises. Lucas?
Good morning, everyone. I hope you're all having a great week. I'm very grateful to soon introduce an incredibly significant person. I would also like to mention how supportive and caring you all have been this year, throughout how brave everyone has been. Think about it. We survived so many quizzes and tests. So although everyone may not know the helpfulness of this individual, she has worked wonders behind the scenes for Buckley's progress. She has undoubtedly been a sympathetic, caring, and knowledgeable person throughout her time at Buckley. Her prudence and wisdom have made Buckley an incredible place. I'm so thankful to introduce Ms. Maceo as our 2021 graduation invocation speaker.
Good morning. Thank you so much, Lucas. That really was, I'm blessed. Anyway, today is a day of great celebration. I thank God for this day, for our graduates, for all their work, and for everyone here who's here to celebrate them. The word I have in my spirit, and I believe God gave it to me today for all of us, for our graduates, our faculty, our parents, our friends. I heard this loud and clear as I was sitting in my office. You are an overcomer. An overcomer is a strong word, not one I would normally say, but it sounds like victory to me. It isn't something that just happens. It means there was sweat, tears, and a battle that took place this year. And let me remind you of some things. This has been an extraordinary year with challenges that we've never faced before, but you face them. You may have gotten weary in the day-to-day battle, but you did not give up. There may have been some difficult days and situations to go through, but you did not quit. And remember, you did not just make it through, you made it work. So today, I say to you this morning, we won. You won. Let's change our perspective on this year to one of victory. Here we are at graduation. Our graduates are all going to great high schools. This is a great win. So let's begin to see ourselves as God sees us this morning. And he says to you today, you are an overcomer. So Father, as we gather here today in victory, we ask that you would release a great refreshing on each one of us. Fill us with your peace and joy this day. Let the victory celebration begin. Amen.
Thank you, Mrs. Mitzel. You are an overcomer. Thank you, Mrs. Mitzel, again, for setting the stage for a beautiful ceremony. And if I may, I would like to share with you a story about the impact that you've had on our students, an impact that you may not even realize. William Davis asked me a week or so ago who would be opening and closing graduation with an invocation and a blessing, as we always do. I responded, Mrs. Maceo. His jaw dropped as he told me that he had had a dream not long before that it would indeed be you. Well, I guess it was a prophetic dream, and dreams do sometimes become reality. Thank you again, Maureen. Good morning. Actually, let me say those two words again, because after everything we've gone through over the past 1 year, 3 months, and 4 days, being together again to celebrate the Buckley class of 2021 does feel like a really good morning. And more than just another day, it feels like the beginning, quite literally the commencement of better days ahead for our graduates and also for all of us. So here we go. Good morning. When the faculty came back to school last September, we started by taking the time to appreciate the meaning of that very moment. Dr. Glennon played a beautiful piece on her cello, and we sat in silence in the Powers family courtyard, appreciating how much it meant to be back together again. So a whole school year later, let's do the same. Let's take in the beauty of this morning and what it's taken for all of us to get here, so that this graduation is not just a check on the end of the year event checklist, but a truly meaningful community moment when we celebrate each individual on the stage today, their families, their friends, and their teachers. Some moments are just too good to let them slip by, and this is one of them. Speaking of families and community, it is always such a pleasure. Brother's joy. So let's now welcome them back properly. Our most recent alum sibling is Ryan Chen of the class of 2020, the only class to have graduated in July last year. Danielle Davis, Rachel Foy, and Michael Morale in the Buckley class of 2019. And Danielle, it's good to have you here. In a way, it is your graduation since you were not able to attend your own. Fabricant in the class of 2018. Vanessa Foy, Isabella Morale, and Gianna Ruggiero in the class of 2017. And by the way, congratulations to all three of you on your college acceptances. And now for the oldest ones of them, Jack Davis and Cameron Perry in the class of 2016. Let's welcome them. Of course, this year, we also have the honor of graduating a third-generation Buckley student, the wonderful Zoe Sean, whose mother graduated in the class of 1992 and her grandfather in the class of 1962. I thought of holding Zoe back a year so that she could be in the class of 2022 to keep this neat pattern going, 62, 92, 22, but didn't work out. Heather and Ed, It is a true privilege to have you here today, and I hope you will enjoy partaking in some of the same traditions you remember from your own respective Buckley graduations. Now is also a good time to recognize our Buckley lifers, those who came to Buckley as cute little toddlers and nursery children and had their very first ever school experience here 12 or 11 years ago. So our toddlers were William Davis, Daniel Laverna, and by the way, those two boys both managed to have us evacuate the building, as at the age of 2 years old, they thought that those red fire pole stations were great toys to play with. They've learned better, hopefully, since then. Also, Olivia Morali, Amalia Sardina, and Lucas Baraccio. And I would like to take this opportunity to announce that 65 years ago today, Lucas's grandparents were here, right in front of me, tied the knot. Happy anniversary, Marilyn and Gasper. I'm not going to ask you what it takes, but we'll talk about it. No, not you, her. And joining them in nursery, we had Lauren Kyung, Maria Ruggiero, and Zoe Shum. Let's give all of our lifers a round of applause. I would also like to recognize three families who came to Buckley together in 2006, 15 years ago. The Davises with Jack and Pre-K, and the Ruggiero and Morali, the Ruggieros and Moralis with Gianna and Isabella in nursery. Thank you for the 15 years during which you have volunteered countless hours to make Buckley not just a school, but also a community. The dates for the 2021 Fall Fair are still TBD, but I'll be in touch, no worries. We have plenty of Italians here, but I'm somewhat embarrassed to confess that some of the life lessons I've learned come from Disney movies. I often think about Rafiki's words in The Lion King, about how we can either choose to run from the past or learn from it. For over a year, we have all been drawn into the same deadly pandemic, and now, of course, we just want to move on and forget about it. Yet, there are lessons that we can learn from what happened that I hope we will remember post-pandemic, especially our young graduates today, as they get a step closer to making their own contributions to society. What first comes to mind to me as an educator and what the pandemic made clear is how much our well-being and our survival depends on science. There's probably much more that we still don't know than what we currently know about how the world works and how the human body thrives, but science has allowed us to make gigantic progress towards a better living. It is how we are beating this virus after all. I was listening to a podcast recently based on a book called Extra Life. The book tries to answer the question of how life expectancy has doubled in the past 100 years, essentially the time Buckley has been in existence. Yes, I will confess that my taste in podcasts is somewhat nerdy, but the book makes the argument that we now live twice as long and better because of scientific discoveries, from antibiotics and penicillin to growing food more efficiently and understanding data-supported patterns. So whether or not you choose a career in science, building upon what we've learned from Ms. Vera and Mr. Prasad, I hope that you will never lose sight of the skills or habits of the mind that all your teachers have taught you, not just your science teachers. The ability to think like a curious, observant scientist, asking good questions, applying your knowledge, challenging established beliefs, including your own, using facts and data, the willingness to always continue learning and seek solutions to big problems, and this idea that you should not feel limited by what people tell you is possible or not possible. Think like a scientist, and at least in this context, do not take no for an answer. Of course, it took more than just science to start getting us out of this mess. Even those of us who are not scientists or frontline workers play the critical role in pushing us towards the end of the tunnel. I can't think of a similar time in our lifetime when as many of our own personal choices had such an impact on the well-being of others, even their survival. And mostly, it was the well-being of people we didn't even know at home or in faraway places. In a sense, we have been forced to be part of the solution. This pandemic has given us a real-life chance to understand the meaning of living a life non-CB, not for self. If we needed a reminder that no man is an island, it was just given to us, courtesy of COVID. Whether we like it or not, we're all connected, and one's choices have real-life consequences on others. The more divided we are, the lesser our chances of continuing to improve our lives. And so that's an important lesson and takeaway from your experience these past 15 months that I hope you keep in mind and carry with you in a post-pandemic world. Now, this pandemic spotlighted the power of human resilience and the ingenuity we are capable of demonstrating when push comes to shove. Think about what you were able to do, what we were able to do with the right can-do attitude. This is, in fact, a really good opportunity now to recognize all of your teachers for their ingenuity and can-do attitude, switching from in-person teaching to remote to hybrid. So let's hear it for our Buckley teachers. And speaking of ingenuity, creativity, and can-do attitude, I think this would also be an opportune time to recognize Mrs. D, who figured out a way to get you on stage and to have not just your very own eighth-grade play, but your own Broadway showstopper. Thank you, Mrs. D. So lesson learned from me, but I hope for you in the future as well, is to always surround yourself with people who are creative, outside-the-box, solution-seekers, and go-getters, willing to try something new. And then finally, and perhaps most importantly and most relevant to you at this point, the pandemic has stretched the limits of the emotional burden we can carry with us every day. Back to Disney for a moment, if I found a magic lamp and a genie granted me a wish for you, it would be this: that you always pay attention to your emotional needs and your mental health, just as much as you care about any other aspects of your health. As one of you suggested in his speech, find out what makes you happy and do it. And know that there's always somebody who's willing to listen to you and lend a helping hand. Last week, the adults who went on your eighth-grade trips with you commented on what a terrific group of people you were. And indeed, you have been an amazing group of students. And I want to thank you in particular for making good on one request I had from you at the beginning of this year. In September, I asked you to be the kind of role models and leaders that we needed for the entire school to make a safe transition back to in-person school. You did not disappoint. And I cannot thank you enough for being the best partners a headmaster could wish for during such a challenging time. So thank you for the encouraging smiles under the masks. I wonder how we will explain things to students 10 or 20 years from now. The masks, pick my kid, the plexiglass dividers, the cohorts, the social distancing, no sports pictures in the 2021 yearbook. I wonder what years from now you will tell people about your senior year at Buckley. My sincere hope is that when you are done with a recounting of the pandemic of 2020-2021, you will tell them that in spite of it all, you made the best of your last year at Buckley, that it was a year of growth, and the other, that you had a terrific year after all. I sure hope to see you back here soon. Thank you. Thank you. So, graduates, congratulations. You are soon to become the newest members of the Buckley Alumni Association. and we want you to keep in touch with your school. So we've asked you to select the class agent. Please welcome Director of Alumni Relations and Class of 2021 parent, Mrs. Jean-Paul, to the podium to announce the name of our newest class agent.
Congratulations, class of 2021. I am very happy to announce our class agent for this year was, drumroll, Tyler.
Congratulations, Tyler, and thank you for agreeing to serve. I am sure that you will do an excellent job, as I have watched your mother set a great example of volunteering at Buckley over the years. We will now, so, congratulations. We will now proceed with the faculty awards, and four are given each year at graduation. The Teacher of the Year Award for 2021 is selected by the member, was selected by the members of the graduating class. It will now be presented by Daniel DeVerne.
This year, the Faculty of the Year Award is presented to a faculty member we've only had for 2 years, but whom you'll surely miss. He's very funny and jocular. He's efficient and able to make the class much more productive. Along with being a great teacher, he was the captain of the Israeli national team for soccer in the 1968 Olympics. This teacher was also very loyal to the Buckley community, this being his 46th year. While our progress was halted for several months due to COVID, we were still able to finish our class. The class of 2021 is ecstatic to present the Faculty of the Year Award on the field named after him to Mr. Roby Young.
Congratulations, Mr. Young, and thank you, Daniel. And yes, Daniel pointed out that this field that we're on now is named the Roby Young Field, so that we all know. The Thomas J. Reed Excellence in Teaching Award. This award is based upon outstanding teaching demonstrated by concern for each other, quality of instruction, and commitment to Buckley. I'm honored to present the 2021 Thomas J. Reed Excellence in Teaching Award to pre-K teacher Christina Kong. The G. Robert Gage Award for Excellence in Teaching. This faculty award, named and given in memory of Mr. Bob Gage's late father and funded through an endowment gift made by the Gage family, is presented annually to a faculty member in recognition of his or her excellence in teaching. The 2021 G. Robert Gage Award for Excellence in Teaching is presented this year to 7th and 8th grade English teacher Maria Newman. Congratulations, Mrs. Newman. There's an envelope behind the certificate, and I'm sure it would come in handy, as in December there's a new arrival plan, right? Congratulations. That's like a Buckley class of 2030 something, right? Congratulations. The Powers Family Teacher Recognition Award. Linda and John Powers made a gift to Buckley's endowment to secure an award to be given annually to a faculty member in recognition of his or her embodiment of the school's character and spirit, care and nurturing qualities, and excellence in teaching. I am thrilled to present the 2021 Powers Family Teacher Recognition Award to Lower School Reading Specialist Alana Reed. Seems like everybody's having life-changing moments. So Mrs. Reedy's was scheduled to be married last summer before the pandemic, and I'm glad to announce that it's been scheduled firmly now for a couple of weeks from now. So congratulations. Only three prizes are awarded each year at graduation. All other prizes were awarded yesterday at the end of the year assembly. In your programs, you will find the names of all the recipients of the 2021 graduation awards. Let's congratulate them and give them a well-deserved round of applause. The three graduation awards given today are academic awards based on grade point average. The third prize is the Certificate of Merit for the students with the third highest academic average in the class. This year's Certificate of Merit is presented to Evelyn Burney. The second prize is a scholarship medal for the student with the second highest academic average in the class. This year's scholarship medal is presented to Lauren Kyung. The first prize presented at graduation is the Trustees Bowl. And I would like to invite Mr. Lee, Chair of our Board of Trustees, to assist me with the presentation of this award. Please welcome Mr. Lee to the podium.
Thank you, Dr. Joel. Good morning, everyone, and congratulations again to all the graduates and your families. All your hard work and sacrifice has paid off. Can we give them another big round of applause to all these fine young men and women here? Before I present this award, I would like to give a little background on the actual Trustees Bowl. The Trustees Bowl was initiated by Mr. Richard Church, who is a founding director here at Buckley. It's the oldest award given to the students. Mr. Church was a businessman, as well as a classical scholar, who actually translated many Greek and Latin books. But more so, he was known to be a very unique individual who marched to his own beat and held academics in the highest regard. With that said, it is my pleasure this morning to present the 2021 Trustees Bowl to Sophia Huang.
Congratulations, Sophia. Where's the Huang family? Over there. Okay, great. So the bowl is there. That's, we gave her a smaller one, but that big one you have to take home also for the summer and bring him back in September. Cleaned and polished. Congratulations. The gift of the class of 2021 will now be presented by outgoing Student Council co-presidents Olivia Morali and Alex Garabaya.
Good morning, faculty, staff, families, students, and the class of 2021. I'm Olivia Morali.
And I'm Alex Garabaya. Olivia and I were honored to be Buckley's co-presidents this year, and we are excited to present this year's class gift.
Thank you to the families of the class of 2021 for donating the class gift. We have decided to raise money for two gifts this year. The first gift that we would like to present is a donation to the athletics department to purchase new equipment. We are proud to be providing Buckley with new and improved equipment to be used during recess and PE classes. Buckley will be able to replace the volleyball and tennis nets. This gift will be greatly appreciated by our PE faculty and students.
Our second gift we would like to present is a donation to the Headmasters Impact Fund, started in 2017 to assist Buckley Country Day School families with expenses above and beyond tuition. The Impact Fund will help Buckley create a more inclusive environment for all families and will be appreciated by all students.
On behalf of the class of 2021, we believe these gifts will be greatly appreciated by the current and future Buckley community.
We are proud to present these gifts from the class of 2021.
First of all, for families who need a little help to be able to afford Buckley above and beyond tuition, this is really terrific. And with new PE equipment, this is terrific. So, Sully, do you want volleyball? So, I'll keep the racket, though, so thank you. Okay. Thank you, Olivia. Thank you, Alex. Soleil and Sabrina, our two sixth grade lead singers for this year's commencement exercises, will now be singing a very special song composed many years ago by Buckley dad and folk singer Oscar Brandt. The lyrics are in the back of your programs.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sabrina. Thank you, Soleil. And thank you, Oscar Brand, as well. Maria Ruggiero will now introduce our faculty speaker.
Good morning, everyone. I am very excited to introduce the 2021 speaker. We can all agree that Mr. Klaus is a teacher that anyone can count on for advice and guidance to make the right decisions and lead us in the right direction. Mr. Klaus does his best to teach us the most important knowledge for history class and for our lives in general, to make us well-prepared and successful students throughout high school and for the rest of our lives. His class encouraged my peers and me to become more comfortable to voice our opinions, and it was a pleasure to experience his teaching techniques throughout the past 2 years. Please welcome Mr. Michael Klaus as this year's graduation speaker.
Thank you, Maria, and thank you to the Buckley class of 2021. This has been a very challenging homework assignment. It is a distinct honor to be one of the last people to stand between you and your Buckley diplomas. Today is my first Buckley graduation, and considering that graduation was a required event prior to the pandemic, this means that everyone in the graduating class has been to more Buckley graduations than I have. This perhaps has been a theme of our 2 years together. I, hopefully, educated you about history, and you, definitely, educated me about Buckley. However, I did a little digging and was told I'm supposed to give you advice. As those in front of me know, no one gives advice to teenagers and expects them to take it. So, like any good student, I did a little more research and read and listened to a lot of graduation speeches. There was advice large and small, serious and humorous, and a lot of stories that really did not apply to anything. I also stumbled upon a beautiful essay by Mary Schmeek of the Chicago Tribune, written in 1997, which I think found that Goldilocks middle. And I will use her format for my remarks to you today. Schmeek's essay, with one slight modification for time, begins as follows, quote, "Ladies and gentlemen of the class of 2021, wear sunscreen. If I could offer you only one tip for the future, sunscreen would be it. The long-term benefits of sunscreen have been proved by scientists, whereas the rest of my advice has no basis more reliable than my own meandering experience. I will dispense this advice now," end quote. Look up. How many of you did I get? There's a beautiful world above the level of your eyes, and an even more beautiful world above that. This is where life is, not looking down at your phones. Make plans, but don't become so attached to them that you miss out on other opportunities. Adapt as needed. Sometimes you end up better off than you imagined in the first place. Read the directions. Resist the urge to think that everything is a competition. Of course you are going to be evaluated and compared, but in the long run, the only competitor in your race is the one you see when you look in the mirror. Don't ever throw out your back. Learn when to say no. In your quest to make everyone happy, you will inevitably fall short. Say what you do and do what you say. Sing at the top of your lungs. If you have no talent in this area, do it where no one can hear you. Embrace not knowing the answers. Try not to wear out your knees. Be nice to your home authority figures. Let them take as many pictures of you as they want. Yes, they are really embarrassing, but you are going to want to remember when life was as simple for you as it is today. Say thank you. Mean it. Find what you are passionate about and do it. You're going to be asked to do a lot, and you will not enjoy most of it. Make time for your passions so you have something to look forward to. Do not be afraid of making mistakes. Instead, be afraid of not learning from them. Show up. Understand, people are a lot more complex and a lot more real than what they post on social media. Do not judge yourself by those standards. To paraphrase Chief Justice John Roberts' address at his own son's middle school graduation, I hope you experience betrayal to learn loyalty, loneliness to appreciate friendship, bad luck to recognize the role of chance, and to quote him, just enough pain to learn compassion. Edit your papers beyond the underlined red, green, and blue words. Remember the feeling of being a Buckley senior, because you are about to be high school freshmen, the very bottom of the hierarchy. Ask upperclassmen for assistance, and don't pretend you know anything, because you don't. Put yourself in situations where you laugh so hard you cry. Accept that meeting new people is awkward. You are not going to say the perfect line, and neither will the person you are meeting. Work to maintain the friendships of those most meaningful to you. Do not let distance win. Find the places that give you stability, and go there when you find yourself a little lost. We are always here. Good days for all, bad days for none, Buckley Class of 2021. Make sure I see you all later. And to finish that Mary Sweet essay, but trust me on the sunscreen. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Klaus, for the all the advice you've given the graduates today, and for all the dermatologists here in the room. We're really excited about the sunscreen. As a matter of fact, I should tell you that yesterday, as a present to all the teachers, among other things, we gave everybody some sunscreen, too. So we really believe in the square sunscreen thing. So thank you so much, Mr. Klaus. Make sure you all see him at the graduation, right? This year's alumni speaker, class of 2016, will now be introduced by his little brother, William.
I am extremely excited and proud to introduce my brother, Jack, as this year's alumni speaker. As Dr. Joel mentioned earlier, when my family first came to Buckley, Jack entered Mrs. Nell's pre-K class. Now, he just finished his first year at Williams College as a potential English major and track athlete. For me, Jack is my best friend. He understands me better than pretty much anyone, demonstrating his funny, caring, and trustworthy personality to me every day. I've always looked up to Jack. Many of the beliefs and values I carry with me today stem from what Jack has taught me and continues to teach me every day. I cannot be more proud to have him as my brother. Throughout Jack's time at Buckley, he achieved many accomplishments and created a great reputation for both me and my sister to follow behind him. Please join me in welcoming Jack. Good morning, everyone. Before I begin, can we please just get another huge round of applause for the amazing, resilient group of graduates of our school. Thank you for the opportunity to come and share my thoughts. The hardest part about writing this speech for me was the introduction. Originally, I wanted it to go like this. Good morning, Dr. Jewell, Mr. Kriegel, Mrs. Lines, faculty, staff, families, friends, the amazing class of 2021. I almost had to stop myself from writing faculty, staff, and my fellow students. I spent 10 years at this school, which means I spent 10 years listening to 30-odd 8th grade speeches a year. At least 20 speeches a year begin with the introduction I just described, including my own. It's effective, formal, respectful, and it methodically addresses everyone in the auditorium. Most importantly, though, it's safe. Whether you spent 1 year or your whole life listening to others' 8th grade speeches, you've seen this intro work time and time again. And when faced with a task as daunting as speaking in front of your peers, teachers, and families, why would we not want to sink into something comfortable? That's what I want to talk about today, a willingness to be uncomfortable. While presenting myself and being presented with new challenges throughout high school, and especially my first year of college, I both struggled and done well at leaning into discomfort. in both scenarios have taught me valuable lessons. One of the most important things I've learned is that a lot of times we have to actively work to make ourselves comfortable. And that's hard, because it's not just realizing that being uncomfortable helps us grow. We're told that often from a young age. It's hard because we have to willingly put ourselves somewhere or do something that we want to avoid. Back at the beginning of March, some of my teammates brought up the idea of living together sophomore year. I had to tell them that I'd already made plans to live with some other folks. Instead of telling them right away, in hopes of avoiding what I thought would be an awkward conversation, I even more awkwardly stumbled through a response that wasn't quite a yes and wasn't quite a no. Fast forward to May 27th, the day before I leave for summer vacation, and I'm standing in front of my mirror saying, come on, you can do this, just tell them, you can do this, I promise. It was silly, but I was petrified. I put this conversation off until I had no choice but to bring it up, and all my small apprehensions towards the conversation had 2 months to snowball into a whole array of irrational, fearful hypotheticals. So I timidly walk into my friend Jacob, who is a really, really nice person, by the way, and I say, look, Jacob, I know we haven't talked about it in a while, but I'm not living with you guys next year. And I brace myself for his harsh rebuke. He replies, oh yeah, we figured that out months ago. None of us are living with each other. Everyone decided to do their own thing. Oh, really? It's silly, and it makes me laugh thinking about how much energy I would have saved myself if I had just been straight up at the beginning. And it shows that the more I tried to avoid an uncomfortable situation that I knew deep down would make everything better, the more harm I caused myself in the process. Obviously, that's a pretty low stakes example, but in other parts of life, the sentiment holds true. Graduates, you all know as well as anyone the world we live in today. Political, racial, and ethnic oppression haunt millions in our country and around the world. Regardless of where we come from or what we believe, it is inhumane to ignore pain. And yet for a lot of us, it's comfortable. No matter how easy it is to stay connected through the internet and social media, it is just as easy to distance ourselves. And yet when we do so, we deprive ourselves of important knowledge and understanding that leads to educated decisions and change. So with all the resources that we have today, why do I go on YouTube to watch videos of Stephen A. Smith and Max Kellerman yell at each other over some ridiculous basketball take, when I could instead be educating myself enough to form opinions and then take action? It's because I'm failing to actively make myself uncomfortable by taking the time to lean into others' conflict. Self-education is about learning when nobody is around to push us, forcing ourselves to work through information for our own benefit. And though it's a skill I continue to try and use effectively, the times I do get it right lead to a lot of good. Luckily, though, just like anything in life, before we can master a skill and use it by ourselves, we have to lean into help. Great teachers give us the tools that we need to take our education into our own hands, and more generally give us the tools we need to push ourselves into personal growth. Both William and Danielle, as begrudgingly as I may admit it, have been catalysts for that many a times, and a lot of those teachers come from Buckley. From trying to keep my elbows off the table at lunch with Ms. Rusak, to learning how to memorize and present poetry in another language with Ms. Zelosky, to getting beat year after year by Max Linovitz in the sit and reach, at school, we're encouraged to grow through discomfort. Now, graduates, your world is getting bigger, in more ways than one. Your grade is so unique, not just because you were the first class to be offered Mandarin instead of French, or to switch from everyday math to Common Core in third grade, but because Buckley's barriers around you lower in time with the world. Masks are dropping, vaccinations are rising, doors are opening just as you all set out on your own paths towards bigger and better things. The world felt a lot bigger to me on the brink of high school. And as the world really does start to get big again, I hope that you all lean into new experiences and don't shy away from challenges. By actively, autonomously shaping our growth through discomfort, we find ways to help ourselves and the people around us. I will continue to do my best to grow alongside all of you, and I look forward to seeing your growth too. Thank you.
Thank you, Jack. So when William introduced Jack, he said that he had been a role model for him and for his sister. And I have to say, having known Jack ever since he started at Buckley, when he was here, he was a role model, not just for his siblings, but for a lot of his peers and many students here. And now he's become a role model for the adults here, so great. Congratulations, Jack, and thank you for sharing your thoughts about leaning into this comfort. The next two speakers have been selected by their peers, and I believe that they are quite excited to tell us about the superheroes and their superpowers in the class of 2021. Please welcome Olivia Morali and Ryan Wu.
Good morning, parents, families, faculty, staff, and the graduating class of 2021. I'm Olivia Morali. Hello, Ryan. How are you?
Great. How are you? My name is Ryan Wu.
Oh, Ryan, time to be professional.
My bad.
On this stage is a class of 31 talented, intelligent, unique, and heroic people. Independently, we each strive for greatness and work hard to succeed. Cooperatively, we are a strong team, and by joining forces, we include all of our distinctive qualities to work toward one goal. Together as the class of 2021, we build upon each other and prosper. We have formed strong relationships with one another, made endless memories, conquered challenges, and grown as one unit.
This one unit is indestructible, and our bonds do not end when we leave Buckley. Memories last, and they keep us together, whether we are physically near each other or not. We are tough, and have helped each other through hard times, like the pandemic. We are able to stay connected and help each other no matter the circumstance, no matter the condition. We have the strength of a superhero, the connection of a team. We are all a powerful team. All of us have abilities almost like a superhero team.
Our individual skills come together to make our everlasting team, and the legacy our class has left at Buckley. The superheroes standing behind me are athletes, students, scholars, champions, artists, and friends. It is hard to associate one superpower with each of these graduating individuals because there are so many standout qualities about themselves. However, each person has one dominant superpower that they have mastered. Buckley is the ultimate powerhouse of heroes. Each one of us possesses courage, outstanding achievements, and noble qualities.
So, without further ado, Olivia and I would like to welcome you all to the
recognition ceremony of the Buckley 2021 Class of Superheroes.
Ava Chan, who has softball skills which are lightning speed to assist people around her. Now she can be known as Lightning Quick.
Tyler Chimmers, her superpower is her ability to hypnotize others and control them. Tyler can even force 31 children to show up to all their 8th grade play rehearsals. She keeps the team organized, and the play would not have been finished without her. She is the manager master.
Zachary Wong, a future pro gamer, is also great at reading. He's all about mythology books, and you'll always find him reading one. He can be known as the mythical gamer for his ability to have endless knowledge about mythical creatures and perfect tactical instinct.
Christian McFarland, future world-famous soccer player, powered by his speed, agility, and size. Christian towers above the rest of the grid in the hallway and makes sure Zach knows about it. Christian's devotion to soccer puts his powers at play. This pro is the field legend.
Daniel DiVerno. If you race him, he's guaranteed to win. Whether on track or on skis, competing in moguls, across, and too many things to mention. especially in field day. Bold, fearless, maybe too much because he broke his arm trying to hang on the basketball hoop. You can call him the Bolt from the Super Speed.
Isabella Luchenko, whose vocals are unbelievably good. Her superpower is her beautiful voice itself, which mesmerizes villains and puts them in a trance. Someday, you will hear her on the radio. Isabella is like a siren, but not evil. You can call her the Rhythmic Slayer.
Alexander Luchenko, a black belt in karate and a great singer. Her superpower is her beauty. Oh. She can fight off any villain using her self-defense and fighting skills and gain infinite support from her beautiful performances. Alexander is now known as the Karate Singer.
Lauren Young, also known as BLL, aka Be Like Lauren, because she is a role model to the team for her diligence in school. Her powers of intelligence and her special photographic memory provide our team with information. She is Mastermind.
Will Davis, future pro basketball player, literally never misses a shot and is practically unguardable. Will uses his otherworldly speed and skills on the basketball court to help him beat any villain while crossing them up in the process. He is the ankle slayer, damaging both ankles and egos on the court.
Lucas Baraccio, whose foods can impress Gordon Ramsay, has the ability to cook the most delicious dishes. Lucas helps the class with biology since he knows everything about the human body and has the power of mixing the right taste and flavors to create perfection. Call him the culinary champion.
Preston Phillips can throw a baseball faster than you could even imagine. His baseball pitching will deceptively curve and then strike a villain dead on. He's also known as Deadeye, not only from his insane skills, but his once fractured face. Jeesh.
Maria Ruggiero. She uses her loving personality to make villains underestimate her toughness. If you mess with her, her strong warrior side will fight you. Maria has the ability to read others' minds, which is why she empathizes so well and takes care of the team. The philanthropic warrior.
Tyler Perry, another soccer legend. You outthink the villain through his pure intelligence and his focus, which is being silent but deadly. He's also known as the ninja with his power of superhuman speed and thinking.
Alex Caraballo. He always has gummy bears in his locker for his friends. My fellow Buckley co-president uses his power of his mega voice to project announcements. This candy lover and enemy defeater can be known as the jaw-breaking chief.
Zach Berger is an unstoppable overall athlete, especially in basketball. He's fierce on the court and the field. He'll outwork any evil and will outperform them in every single facet of athleticism. He can be known as the all-around beast.
Zoe Schoen, a book lover and a scholar. Zoe has limitless knowledge about literacy and has a passion for books. Zoe has the power of super reading and can read at a rapid speed. Zoe can be known as Bookworm Woman.
Sam Giroux, a hockey god, and a great class comedian. He's great on the ice hockey rink and can make the villain burst out in laughter at will. He's also known as the hockey legend with his superpower of speed while skating on the ice.
Giselle Chan, future famous women's basketball player. Giselle has the superpower of super speed, which helps her bolt across the court and suddenly have the best snacks at school to share. Giselle can also be ultra beast.
Joey John Paul, who's an amazing actor. She's the activist, her superpower being able to instantly convince anyone to join a movement.
Aveen Bernie, or Aveeny Weenie. Aveen possesses strong insight into any current event going on in the world and is might be addicted to Twitter. Aveen uses her teleportation power to watch events around the world to gather information for the team. She is Megamind.
David Prevol, the soccer demigod. He's able to use his athleticism to score a goal at will. You power through any defensive schemes, and there's literally nothing you can do to stop it. He's a sports juggernaut with the superpower of beating anyone at any sport.
Savina Foy, an amazing athlete on the volleyball court and soccer field by using her power of super speed and strength for her kicks and hits. Savina is competitive, besides when making it to school on time when she lives right over there. She is the sharpshooter.
Gabby Wongi. She's a great singer and is very supportive of civil rights. She'll give the perfect motivational speech for preparation and fight the hardest in battle. She's our performance warrior with her power to make everyone on her side perform 150% better.
Madison Kenner, a loving and talented volleyball player who laughs or shares jokes with anyone. No matter what the joke is, Madison will always laugh. Her power is her contagious laugh used to infect her enemy and put them to sleep. Madison is the giggly goddess.
Amalia Sardina. She's one of the most passionate people in our class. If our team needs any skill to fall back on, Amalia is the one to look for. She's the Renaissance woman. For her superpower to pick up any skill almost instantly.
Ava Kuhn, a quiet but a deadly superhero. Most people would think Ava would never hurt you, but she can annihilate her enemies. Ava watches out for the superhero team and uses her healing powers with the magical touch of her hand. Ava is the great attendant.
Sophia Huang, the expert. She'll decode the hardest problems and is one of the first members you'll ask to help make decisions for the team. She's called the problem solver. For her superpower to pretty much see into the future before she makes any answer to any problem.
Rebecca Fabricant knows every TikTok dance and often gets her phone taken by Mr. Klaus because of them. Besides TikTok, Rebecca is an amazing dancer and destroys her enemies with her spins, splits, and moves powered by her extreme flexibility. She is Whirling Woman.
Sandhya Srinivasan, whose academics and basketball skills are super strong. She can create entire attack schemes for villains before they can even start to think of a defense. She's an academic baller, using her superpower of slowing down time to think or to make a game-winning shot. Bang.
Wow, I almost forgot about my fellow speaker, Ryan Wu. One of the team's personal trainers is built of steel and can bench press thousands of pounds. Ryan defeats his enemies with his powerful punch, and he enhances his teammates' strength. His power is being an indestructible force shield. Ryan can be known as Mega Hulk.
Thank you, Olivia. Olivia, the team's other personal trainer and a workout fanatic. She's a lacrosse demigod and uses her training to help her performance on the field. She'll speed right past you and will make any defense spin in circles with her quick agility and power. Olivia is the other co-president and is a great leader for a superhero team. She's the lacrosse lead with her power of super strength and speed. Wow, somehow we chose a superpower that each of our peers hold. Although we narrowed these down to only a few abilities per person, we know that each person has much more in store, that their values extend much further than what we selected. Nonetheless, these superheroes hold powers that contribute and make the class of 2021's superhero team the vigorous and victorious team it is.
The most important trait relevant across all individuals standing behind me is potential. We are all ready to extend our horizons and strive for more. On this stage, we have heroic people who are prepared for a successful and even brighter future ahead of them.
The class of 2021 would not be what it is that our teachers, faculty, and staff encouraging, supporting, and looking after us in every way possible. Thank you for working hard to make Buckley the way it is and for preparing us for the future. We appreciate everything that you have done for our class to help us succeed. Work hard and sacrifice your time for us. Who we are. Thank you to our families who support and love us in everything we do. Our families are all our backbone, and we owe literally everything to all of you. Lastly, thank you to the class of 2021. Thank you for all the fun memories, moments, games, lunches, laughs, even Google Meets. Thank you for helping each other grow into who we are and for being there for each other every step of the way.
After we graduate from Buckley, we will continue our individual journeys. However, we will never forget the laughs and memories we have shared, the dedication and perseverance we had as a class, and the strong and different personalities that each of us holds will always be remembered. In the future, we will continue to use the determination we have built to live our lives to our best potentials and use our superpowers to make an impact on the world. The class of 2021 will leave behind a legacy and the remembrance of heroes who consistently showed courage and devotion to their school. We are moving on as a graduating class, but we will always have a place for Buckley and each other in our hearts. Thank you.
I think we should go. give Olivia and Ryan another round of applause for... encapsulating the superpowers in the class of 2021 so beautifully in their speech. So let us all stand now and join in singing Gaudeamus Igitur to our superheroes. And with our superheroes, it means let's rejoice, so let's sing joyfully. I think there's some work to do here with the audience, so brushing up on our Latin a little bit. Thank you to our beautiful singers. And now for the presentation of the diplomas. Newly elected co-presidents of the 2021-2022 Student Council, Anna Byung and Kyle Lee, will help the graduates display their plaques. As you know, and this has been a tradition since 1927, the plaques the eighth graders have carved will be hung up on the walls of our school and remain there forever. While the diplomas are presented to the students, I do ask that you please hold your applause so that we can hear their advisors read excerpts from teachers' comments that I pulled out of their files some time ago. Those comments were written by the students' teachers over the years, from toddler to as recently as this year. Mr. Lee will help me with the presentation of the diplomas now, and eighth grade advisors, we're ready.
Zachary Berger. Zach demonstrates a remarkable level of effort and performance. His level of interest is matched with great diligence. He is quick to become engaged in the task at hand. Zach comes to class with a sense of enthusiasm that is unmatched. He is quick with a greeting and also an answer. No sooner than I am finished with a question is he willing to suggest that he has an answer. I honestly think that he believes that the class would be better if it were just the two of us in conversation. I look forward to seeing his development as a student of science. Mr. Roger Prasad, science teacher.
Lucas Vito Baraccio. Lucas is a sweetheart. I'm so lucky to spend time each week with him. He is truly a delight, and he takes his playing job very seriously. He especially loves to play with the trains and cars and sweep and cook in the kitchen area. I have loved every minute of the time I spent with him this year. He is such a sweet little guy and is a delight to have in our class. He is helpful and kind and gets along well with everyone. Lucas is truly a delight. Mrs. Lori Zwick, toddler teacher.
Avine Bernie. Avine is a happy, optimistic little girl who always sees the best in every person and situation, a quality that adults aspire to possess. She is enthusiastic about learning and takes great pride in mastering new skills and concepts. Her strong work ethic and perseverance have been at the core of her every success. Avine is a friend to all, always willing to lend a hand. Her good natured spirit makes her a favorite among her classmates as well as her teacher. I feel blessed to be Avine's teacher. She has filled my year with sunshine. Mrs. Hillary Gannick, first grade teacher.
Jacob
Alejandro Carvalho. Alex's positive attitude and magnetic personality make him a leader amongst his peers. He is friendly, passionate, and popular. When Alex takes interest in a text, he beams with enthusiasm and makes predictions by drawing inferences. He is eager to participate in class discussions and works well within any group. Alex is warm and inviting. Alex is unafraid to go out on a limb in his work. He is creative and confident. I wish him all the best. Mrs. Maria Newman, English teacher.
Ava Elizabeth Chan. Ava is the eyes and ears of our class. She is alert to everything that is going on and immediately informs the teachers if anything is at all amiss. Ava likes all of her peers. We have never seen her turn away a friend. If the game sounds like fun, then Ava is happy to play with whomever wants to join in. Ava likes to be helpful. As the children sit to begin a project, Ava participates and anticipates their needs and gets out the crayons. Likewise, she passes out the plates and silverware before she takes her seat at the lunch table. It has been a delight having Ava in our room. Mrs. Susan Goldman, pre-K teacher.
Giselle Harris Chan. Giselle is a delightful and charming young lady who is well-liked and respected by her peers. Giselle is a lovely girl with a warm smile and a big heart. Her bubbly, considerate nature shines throughout the year. Not a day goes by without Giselle smiling or offering a helpful hand. If a peer is feeling down or needs a compliment, Giselle is always there to comfort her classmates. Giselle is as lovely on the inside as she is on the outside. She is truly a well-rounded individual and a fabulous addition to our Buckley community. Giselle is ready to meet the challenges and expectations ahead. Mrs. Lynn Knox, fourth grade teacher. William Vegas. William has truly been a pleasure to teach this year. He is a very bright boy. He is so helpful around the room. He has amazing classroom behavior and is always ready for the next activity. He is always so proud of his finished work, and we are proud of him as well. William plays well with his classmates and is extremely sweet. He is a joy to teach. He has truly made me laugh and smile every single day. I have loved being his teacher. Mrs. Leanna Lombardo, pre-K.
Daniel Patrick Laverna. Daniel is an all-around terrific kid. He has a lot of real-life knowledge. Recently, he pointed out some holes in one outdoor wooden playhouse. "We need to call the exterminator," he told us. "I know about this." We answered that we would share that information with Dr. Joel. When we went back inside, Dr. Joel was in the hallway. Daniel marched right up to him and explained the situation and what needed to be done. He has a strong sense of right and wrong and does not just follow the crowd. Daniel is a favorite among his peers and never lacks a playmate. Daniel thinks strategically and plays to win. He is polite and respectful to his teachers, as well as his peers. He's a delight to have in our class. This is Susan Goldman, pre-K teacher. Rebecca Ivy Fabricant. Rebecca enters our classroom each morning with a cheerful smile, ready to work. Rebecca is extremely sociable and works with maturity. Classmates are always willing to work with her, and she's always cheerful, as well as a classmate who shows a true desire to succeed in school. Working with Rebecca is a true pleasure. Her classmates and I appreciate her infectious smile, creativity, and work ethic. I will miss her boundless energy. I wish Rebecca much happiness and success. Ms. Denise Powers, fourth grade teacher. Savina Marie Foy. Savina has been a pleasure to have in class this year. Savina is a sweet, friendly young lady who is always ready to lend a helping hand. She takes pride in her work and attacks each task with effort and determination. Savina is a friend to all. She is spunky. I am proud of how she pushed herself to be the best and how she has grown as a student throughout the year. It was truly a pleasure getting to know Savina this year, and I look forward to watching her grow through her time at Buckley. Ms. Stephanie Rosenthal, second grade teacher.
Sophia Wong. Sophia is the epitome of a student who loves to demonstrate her mastery of the information she has garnered. Sophia is quick to adapt to new experiences and determines how she might be able to assimilate new information into what she already knows. Comfortable working independently and collaboratively, it is this fluidity of her being that is most impressive. It is quite interesting to watch, but it seems that Sophia appreciates learning as much as she does explaining information to another classmate. It is these moments that Sophia shines. Mr. Roger Prasad, science teacher. Josephine Simone Jean-Paul. What can I say about Joey? She is dedicated, helpful, organized, and a great self-advocate. She comes to class ready to learn every day. If Joey ever has a question, she doesn't hesitate to ask. She is fearless and asks insightful questions. I am sure that her classmates are very happy that Joey is able to ask questions that sometimes they haven't even thought about. It is a true pleasure teaching Joey. Mrs. Sue Rodriguez-McLean, mathematics teacher.
Madison Kenner. Madison quietly enters her room each day and settles right down to her independent morning work. She brings an aura of peacefulness to our days. She works successfully with a partner or group, no matter who she is placed with. Madison is a source of calm and cooperation and is always willing to help a classmate or offer a reassuring smile. Compassionate, amiable, respectful, and hardworking are just some of the traits her teachers next year will spot right away. Her friendliness, maturity, and sincerity foster a positive classroom environment. I look forward to seeing where Madison's ambitions guide her. I wish her all the success and happiness she deserves. Mrs. Denise Powers, fourth grade teacher.
Ava Kuhn. Ava is a sweet, caring first grader who always comes to school with a smile. She is enthusiastic about learning new things each day and takes great pride in her accomplishments. I have thoroughly enjoyed being Ava's teacher this year. I admire her lovable, playful personality and her ability to see the positive in every situation. I will certainly miss Ava, but I will send her on to the lucky second grade teachers as she is ready, willing, and able to tackle the challenges ahead. Mrs. Hillary Janik, first grade teacher. Lauren Sadie Kyung. Lauren is delightful to have in class. She is a sweet little girl who happily enters the classroom every day. She hesitates for just a moment each morning when it's time to say goodbye to mom, but then she immediately switches gears. Lauren enjoys conversations with her classmates and the give and take of ideas as a parent. Her hand always shoots up to be the first to share an answer. Lauren gets along very well with all her peers and never lacks a playmate. It is a delight having Lauren in class. We look forward to watching her progress in the years ahead. Mrs. Susan Goldman, pre-K. Alexandra Maria Luchenko. Alexandra enters our room each day with a warm greeting and a cheerful smile. Alexandra takes her work seriously, and she shows a true desire to succeed. She is cooperative, compassionate, creative, and full of curiosity, and a valued member of our learning environment. Considerate, artistic, and bright are qualities her teachers will readily see in Alexandra. I wish her much success and happiness and success, Denise Powers, fourth grade teacher.
Isabella Helene Lukchenko. Isabella is a delightful and charming young lady who is well-liked and respected by her peers. Her positive, accepting nature is infectious. Isabella can work with anyone in our class and has a natural, calm way of getting her group motivated. Isabella is a kind, soft-spoken fourth grader who is always wearing a smile. I am certain that her intelligence, compassion, and drive will help her obtain her life goals. It was a delight working with such an adorable young lady. I will surely miss her smile and kind disposition. Mrs. Lynn Knox, fourth grade teacher.
Olivia Jean Morale. Olivia is a very bright girl. She strives to follow directions and meet expectations at all times. She works very well with all of her classmates. She is very comfortable with her teachers and often shares stories from home with us. She's talkative and happy at school, and although she pretends not to, she's always smiling. She's very sweet and has a great sense of humor and is so much fun. Her smile and quiet personality have helped make my year fantastic. Olivia is truly a pleasure to teach. Ms. Liana Lombardo, pre-K teacher.
Christian H. McFarland. Christian took on the task for the We Lead course with leadership and a sense of responsibility. The very nature of the program provided a place for Christian to feel empowered with a sense of purpose. The willingness to make a difference in how we care for others is evident in Christian's responses in class discussions. Christian demonstrates empathy and compassion and knows that a simple act of kindness could start with one small step. I look forward to seeing what actions Christian will take towards making caring common. Ms. Patricia Rosak, history teacher.
Tyler Matthew Perry. Tyler's bright smile and kindness have made him a very beloved member of the classroom community. Tyler has an innate sense of right and wrong and does his very best to make sure that he, as well as his classmates, are following all the rules all the time. Each day, I am blown away with Tyler's kindness and chivalrous nature. He is an extremely special young man who I am convinced will grow up and show the world just how special and amazing he is. I am truly going to miss having him in my class. Tyler's infectious smile and wonderful sense of humor make him a beloved member of the Buckley community. Ms. Jessica Raphael, second grade teacher. Preston Craig Phillips. Preston is always an energetic and polite presence in class. I love that Preston is always willing to hazard a guess at a tough question and volunteer an opinion for debate. Preston is so energized and active in class, whether in person and online. Preston has a great sense of humor and hilarious reactions to his peers. Preston is always game for a good-natured argument, and I've enjoyed teaching Preston this year. Mr. Michael Klaus, history teacher.
David Isaiah Praval. David is a spirited first grader who approaches his schoolwork with a sense of wonder and curiosity. He is enthusiastic about learning and takes great pride in mastering new concepts. His eagerness to attempt anything set before him is inspiring. Whether it is a math activity or a game of tag on the playground, David enthusiastically participates. He is a true friend to his classmates, constantly looking out for their best interest. I thoroughly enjoyed being David's teacher this year. Mrs. Hillary Janik, first grade teacher.
Maria Marion Ruggiero. Maria is a happy little girl. She's sweet, thoughtful, fun-loving, and imaginative. How wonderful it is that she usually starts the day with reading favorite or new books from the bookshelf. Maria delights us all with her imaginative qualities at playtime, particularly thinking up new and fun pretend scenarios for her friends. She's well sought after playmate, able to share, take turns, resolve conflicts, and express her feelings. It has truly been a pleasure to have Maria as a member of our nursery class. We will miss our resident maven on all things Disney. Mrs. Ann McGivney, nursery teacher. Amalia Elizabeth Sardina. I very much enjoy the time I spend with Amalia each week. She's a happy, confident, and capable young lady. Amalia confidently comes through the door and gets right to her playing. She is a real self-starter. Amalia is always sweet and kind and saying thank you to her friends when they share a toy with her. How lucky I am to have spent this year with Amalia. Amalia is a pure delight. Mrs. Lori Zwick, toddler teacher.
Zoe Waverly Show. I remember the quiet little first grader sitting at my lunch table like it was yesterday. Zoe now slips into our room each day with a warm greeting. She is interested in learning from others' points of view and demonstrates confidence in articulating her ideas. Zoe is responsible, sensible, creative, and cooperative. Her peers always enjoy working with Zoe, as she is constantly a source of hard work and peaceful demeanor. Always ready to assist a classmate and teacher, things run more smoothly when Zoe is involved. What will I do without her reassuring smiles next year? I wish Zoe much happiness and success. Ms. Denise Powers, fourth grade teacher. Sandhya Srinivasan. Sandhya is a very special young lady. She's a kind, sweet, funny, and loving girl. She's an outgoing and thoughtful individual who shows kindness and compassion towards her classmates on a regular basis. Sandhya's acts of kindness combined with her fun-loving disposition have made her a beloved and well-respected second grader. I'm convinced that Sandhya's kind heart and generous nature will only continue to garner praise and respect from everyone she meets. Ms. Jessica Raphael, second grade teacher.
Tyler Zoe Timmers. Tyler is a confident young lady who comes to school each day ready to learn. She's a dedicated student who relishes the challenges of school. She starts each day eager to learn and share her thoughts and opinions. I can always count on her hands to be the first one to respond. She loves to engage us in her family stories. Tyler's bubbly personality, smiling face, and candid positive attitude has helped in her success this year. It was truly a pleasure getting to know Tyler this year, and I look forward to watching her grow through her time at Buckley. Mrs. Stephanie Rosenthal, second grade teacher. Zachary Z1. Zach loves to read. He can always be found with a book in his hand. A critical thinker, Zach has been known to read passages in search of symbolism, imagery, and other elements of the author's craft. His thoughtful contributions inspire others to dig deeper into analyzing the class novels and exploring larger themes of literature. It is a pleasure to have such a book enthusiast in class. Mrs. Maria Newman, English teacher.
Gabrielle Irene Wongbeck. Gabby is a thoughtful reader, always determined to finish what she starts. Gabby is unafraid to seek out feedback and takes time outside of class to ensure her work exceeds the expectations set for her. Gabby's independence and sense of responsibility allow her to easily adapt to both collaborative and independent learning environments. She's a natural leader who takes initiative in a way that is sensible and efficient. Ms. Maria Newman, English teacher.
Woo. Ryan brings a positive work ethic to class daily. He has the ability to recall topics that were studied a while back and then assess them at a point that he determines to be relevant. This ability serves to let him develop the connections that are required to bring about a deeper understanding of the topic. Should an idea seem elusive, the desire to further pursue it intensifies. Ryan approaches problem solving with an open mind. He is able to link disparate ideas and quite willing to try a different approach. Despite his reserved approach, he is never one to accept the conclusion of a partner without being sure of it himself. Mr. Roger Persad, science teacher.
Sam J. Zaru III. Sam has demonstrated a remarkable work ethic. He's a very open learner, willing to reveal his thinking. This is the direct result of his dedication to learning the new material. In class, he engages in a stepwise approach to the work in front of him. In collaborative activities, Sam takes a leadership role and can be quite emphatic in his arguments. He works to ensure that all tasks are properly completed and that everyone is aware of their role. All details are tended to, and he meets with a remarkable performance. It has been wonderful to witness Sam's diligence. Mr. Roger Persad, science teacher.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the class of 2021. Thank you. I will now ask Joey Jean-Paul to come forward and present this year's 8th grade musical offering.
See You Again, because the message relates to us. Last year, when we went online, we weren't able to see each other and socialize as we used to. When we came back at the beginning of the year, we were all excited to see and talk to each other. We felt like no time has passed. The song focuses on sharing the good old days and reuniting with each other in the near future. The song also shows that even if we are away from each other for a long time, when we reunite, it will feel like nothing has changed. As we all graduate and go on our separate paths, wherever that may be, we all know that we will see each other again here at Buckley. Now, the class of 2021 presents See You Again by Wiz Khalifa featuring Charlie Puth.
Thank you, Dr. Clark. Thank you to our eighth graders, and may every step you take from here on always take you back home to Buckley. Okay, let's stand again and sing America the Beautiful together. We will sing both verses. The words are in your programs.
Bye.
Mrs. Missale, please come and bless us all. God knows we need your blessings.
This was amazing, amazing, amazing. I'm so thankful for each one of our graduates, and we ask now that the blessing be released upon each one of them. Father, we ask that you guide them with your peace and wisdom. You surround them with love and protection wherever they go. Let the favor be upon them. Open doors of opportunity for each and every one of them. And then wherever they find themselves, let them never forget who they are and how much they are loved. We ask you to bless the rest of our day. Let this celebration be one of great victory. We thank you for this blessing. Amen.
I'd love to start summer thinking about these words by Henry James. He wrote, summer afternoon, to me, those have always been the two most beautiful words in the English language. We had to skip summer 2020, so let's make sure that this one counts for two. I wish you all a safe and wonderful summer. The school year is over. Graduates will now lead the procession, followed by their advisors and administrators. Eighth grade parents can stay in your seat until the faculty have left the tent area. All eighth grade parents and friends are invited to join us in the Powers family courtyard for refreshments. Have a great, great summer, everybody.
Thank you.